Good evening, people, to your Bikes with a Message live, and let me see, see if we're on here. Yeah, we're on. And good evening from Pullman, Washington, and welcome everyone from Rumble and YouTube and Facebook. And I just want to say hi, and this is my bike ministry. It's called Bikes with a Message, and I fix up for a low price. Sorry about that. It's 6 o'clock. So, anyways, what I was saying is, this is my bike ministry. It's called Bikes with a Message, and I fix up for a low price. I also sell for a low price bikes, and 10% of the money goes down to Mexico and to people that are in poverty, and take a ride with Jesus. You can contact me at Martin P. Anderson. My phone number is 208-669-0456. And my address is 1155 Southeast Professional Mall Boulevard, Trailer 423. And I'm in Pullman, Washington, 99163. And my email is marchchildofjesus316@gmail.com. And so what we were talking about last weekend was... oh, yeah. So if you need a bike, you can get a hold of me, and I can sell your bike or fix your bike up. Or if you want to donate to my ministry, that'd be fine too. And lately, you know, I've been kind of like, are you, God, do you really want me to do this still? And then people are like, no, keep on doing it. I'm like, okay. So if you guys want to help me out with people that are in poverty, and my mom's snoring over here. Yeah. She's snoring over here. She's been busy on Special Olympics. She's gonna be swimming. And so I'll be praying for her that she doesn't have a seizure during the events. And but it won't be until May. So anyways, so if you want to get a hold of me and I can maybe talk Jesus with you, or sell a bike to you, or fix up a bike, you're welcome to come in and visit or buy a bike from me. So anyways, what we were talking about in Job is we were talking about where Satan was allowed to do anything to Job, but God told Satan, do not touch my kid. So, or touch his, you know, his son. And so it's almost like what happened to Jesus, and also with, you know, another character in the Bible. It was I think it was Lazarus or something like that. Anyway, or no, it was I've forgotten what we were talking about. Anyway, what we're gonna talk about this time in Job 3 is Job is gonna be cursing his life. And so I know people are like, why would he curse his life? Well, he had boils, but he was not gonna curse God. So And it's different between cursing God and unseeing your circumstances because he didn't do anything wrong. And God did not do anything wrong. Didn't do anything wrong. God was testing Job. So anyways, let's open up with prayer and let's get started. Father God, thank you for your word. Thank you for your son, Jesus. Thank you, God, for everything you've done, Lord. Thank you for a beautiful day. Thank you, God, that you are the creator and judge of the universe. Thank you, God. Praise you. Thank you, God. I pray that you would just be with us as we study your word. And thank you, God. Praise you. In Jesus' name. Amen. So, anyways, heading into Job 3. And let's get started with our first slide. So Job 3, 1 through 26. After this, Job opened his mouth and cursed the day of his birth. And Job said, let me see if I can get toned down a little bit. Okay. And Job said, let the days perish on which I was born, and the nights that I said, I am conceived. Let that day be darkness. May God above not seek it, nor light shine upon it. Let gloom and darkness claim it. Let the clouds dwell upon it. Let the blackness of the day terrify it. That night, let thick darkness seize it. Let it not rejoice among the days of the year. Let it not come into the number of the month. So that's crazy. I mean, Job is really, he's mad, but he's not mad at God. He's mad at the day of his birth. See? Behold, let that night be barren. Let no joyful cry enter it. Wow. That's crazy. So, he's not mad at God. He's not cursing God. He's mad because of the boils. He's like, why am I born? You know, it's almost like some atheists say, oh, I'm just a clump of cells. You know, I am nothing but nothing. That's crazy talk. See, that's where Job is at. But he didn't curse God. Atheists, they curse God because they hate God. They love themselves, but they hate God. Job, he loved God, but he hated himself. See, he was like, why do I mean, everything's been taken away from me. See, everything is being taken away. And he's like, why am I born? I didn't do anything wrong. But see, he hates the situation he's in. Mm-hmm. And verse 8, let those curse it who curse the day, who are ready to arouse Leviathan. So Leviathan, this is what Leviathan is.
Strong's H 3882. Leviathan.
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 Let me see if I can get that. Okay, so Leviathan, and it means Leviathan, a sea monster, dragon, large aquatic animal, perhaps the extinct dinosaur, a plesiosaur, extinct meaning unknown. So, and then you go down farther, you read here, additional information from outline of biblical use. Some think this to be a crocodile, but from the description in Job 41, verse 1 through 34, this is partly it appears to be a large fire-breathing animal of sorts, just as the abominable beetle has a explosion producing mechanism so the great street sea dragon may have been an explosive producing mechanism to able it to be a real fire breathing dragon. So, I hope you guys can see what I'm showing here, but isn't that crazy? I mean, that's what it's saying here in Job 3. So in Job 3, that's what the Leviathan is. And I have a video of Leviathan, a biblical monster, mythological beastly. So I hope I don't get a commercial. I'm not promoting this. I'm not promoting this. Sorry, guys.
According to the Old Testament, there is a giant creature in the ocean's depths. His name is Leviathan. According to the sacred text of Jews and Christians, like all creatures that walk on land, fly in the air, and swim in the waters, Leviathan was also one of God's creations. This creature is described in the book of Job, where God himself describes this colossal monster. The beast resembles a huge marine dragon. Men would be consumed by fear whenever they spotted him. No man is brave enough to dare to awaken such a creature, since the idea of defeating it would be nothing but an illusion. God himself describes the mighty Leviathan as a colossal creature, the bearer of incredible power. The huge monster creates massive waves when moving. His powerful mouth has dreadful teeth. His back is protected by rows of shields so close together that not even air can pass between them. Leviathan has a powerful blow that throws flashes of light. There's fire in his mouth and smoke in his nostrils. When this beast rises, even the most powerful run away terrified. because swords, spears, and arrows can do nothing against a creature who has his chest as hard as the most resistant stone. Nothing on earth can compare to Leviathan's power. But such a creature owes its existence to God's desire, since, like every human being, Leviathan can only have their food due to the grace of God. The beast was the inspiration for the English philosopher Thomas Hobbes in his work Leviathan. According to Hobbes, the man in his natural state, where there are no laws, tends to unleash an all-against-all quarrel. To eliminate this state of anarchy, there has to be a social pact where everyone relinquishes part of their sovereignty in the name of a figure who has absolute power. This figure that would have authority over men would be the state, which, due to its power before men, Hobbes compares with the gigantic biblical monster known as Leviathan.
Are you ready?
Isn't that cool, though? Just like, guys. Okay. Sorry about that. Okay. Jump 40. Biblical. Okay. So, isn't that cool? Like, where the Bible talks about dragons? I mean, matter of fact, in Job 40, verse 15, it says, Behold, behemoth, as I made you, he eats grass like an ox. So, the description there is it's a land animal, and but with the Leviathan, it was a land animal, or a sea creature, I meant. Like a plesiosaur, and I should have had a video on the plesiosaur, but I didn't have time. I just slapped it together, so with this, and so if you want to look up the video, it's on YouTube, and it's like you can look up on Answers in Genesis YouTube channel, and they will explain the dinosaurs. And so the word dinosaur wasn't invented until 1841 by Sir Richard Owens, and he was trying to figure out what these creatures were, so he named them dinosaurs. But most unlikely it was because the word dragon is in the Bible. It's more like of a fire-breathing dragon. So anyways, that's what with the Leviathan, that's the same thing. So anyways, moving on to verse 9 in Job 3. Because we're in chapter 3. Let the stars of its dawn be dark. Let it hope for light, but have none, nor see the eyelids of the morning, because it did not shut the doors of my mother's womb, nor hide trouble from my eyes. Why did I not die at birth? Come out from the womb and expire. So Job is asking himself, like, why was I born? Why was I not die? You know, why didn't I die in my mother's room? It's because God kept him alive. God formed him. Matter of fact, in Psalms 139, 13 through 14, for you formed my inner parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. My soul knows it very well. So I have a video of, and I hope I don't get a... Isn't that cool? Some people say it's Gilslitz right here, but no, that's not true. That round thing around the baby is the placenta. It feeds the baby, it houses the baby, it gives a whole bunch of stuff to the baby. That's at 9 weeks. That's crazy. I'm on right now. Yeah, see everyone, that's where we came from. That's where you came from. And so, let me get back. Hope I don't have to start. Oh, sorry, guys.
I hope I wasn't snoring.
Oh, no, it's fine. That's why I was waking you up. verse 15 of 139, it says, my frame was not hidden from you. When I was being made in secret, indulgently, is that how you spell that? How you say that, Mom? Mom?
Intelligently?
Okay.
Oh, intricately.
Okay. So, let's see. Oops. Sorry, guys. So, this is what this means. It means, let me see if I can.
Intricate.
Okay. So, I'm trying to get rid of. So, get these commercials popping everywhere. So, it means having many complexities in triggering, interrogating parts of element or elements. So, yeah. Isn't that cool? Like, woven in the depths of the earth.
What? Do you have how they pronounce that word?
Nah, I don't. Well, I mean, hold up. Maybe I can go back into it. So.
Intricate.
Yeah, okay. So. So verse 16, your eyes saw my unformed substance. In your book were written every one of them, the days that were formed for me, when as yet there was none of them. So Job 3:12 through 26, why did the knees receive me, or why the breasts that I should nurse? So all everything that Job's going through is summed up in John 10:10. The thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. I come that they may have life and have it abundantly. So God came to save, yes, even Job. Job, he was going through a hard time because he was like, I want to curse the day of my birth. I'm not going to curse you, God. I'm going to curse the day of my birth.
I went and threw that.
And so...
Terry, I'm waiting.
And so...
Bucket.
Uh-oh. So, that's why everything that Job is going through, why did the knees receive me, or why the breast that I should nurse? This is Job. I mean, literally, he is so, like, so confused, but he's not gonna curse God.
Yeah.
You know? So Job 3:13-26, for when I would have laid down and be quiet, I would have slept. Then I would have been at rest. Basically, he wishes he was dead. with kings and counselors of the earth, who rebuild ruins for themselves. Sounds like America today.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sounds like that we're destroying, but also we're trying to rebuild, which is sin.
Yeah.
You know, we're rebuilding what has been taken care of in the past. See, like the slavery or the abortion thing. We would rather die and curse God. But Job's not doing that.
Mm-mm.
Job, he is wishing he's dead, but he would not curse God. God didn't do anything to him. God allowed Satan to go after him. But on the other hand, God was doing something. He was testing Job. And Job, he didn't curse God. See, he didn't curse God. He didn't say anything about God. You know, he didn't say, oh, God, you are terrible. You gave me these boils. He didn't do what Adam did. He didn't do what Adam did. He didn't say, wow, you see that woman that you gave me? He didn't do that.
Mm-mm.
Job, he didn't do that. He was like, I wish I was dead. And so, on the other hand, he's in the image of God, you know? And it's kind of weird when you look at it like that. You could say, well, maybe he was cursing God, but that's not what the scripture says.
Yeah, yeah.
See, you can get the picture of like, wow, if he's cursing the day of his birth and God made him, you could say that he was cursing God, but he wasn't. See? And so, so in verse 15, or with princes who had gold, who filled their houses with silver. Or why was I not as a hidden stillborn child, as infants who never see the light? There the wicked cease from troubling, and there the weary are at rest. There the prisoners are at ease together. They hear not the voice of the taskmasters. The small and the great are there, and the slave is free from his master. Okay. You can basically go back to Egypt, and then they are free. Because there's a new master came in, and that was God. Why is the light given to him who is in misery and life to the bitter in soul? So, have you ever felt like that way Job was? Where God is testing you, and then Satan is coming after you, and you don't even curse God. I'm at that point right now in my life, you know, because, and my mom, she doesn't even do that, and I don't even do that. But there's people out there that do that. Because they blaming God for the troubles in their life. See? And that's where Job is, but he did not curse God. Who longed for for death, but it comes not and digs for it more than for hidden treasure, who rejoice exceedingly and are glad, and when they find the grave. Why is light given to a man whose way is hidden from God? Has heart, what is that? It's hedged in. So hedging is carved. For my sight, my sign comes instead of my bread, and my groaning are poured out like water. For the things that I fear comes upon me, and what I dread befalls me. I am not at ease, nor am I quite. I have no rest, but trouble comes. So, isn't that crazy? Where even though God is not saying anything to Job, he's testing him, and Job is not cursing God. See, he's asking these questions, and see, most people, they would be like, why did you do this, God? Why did you do that? Why was I born? God? No, Job didn't do that. He was just asking these questions, and he didn't curse God. Isn't that crazy? I mean, I know why I was born. Because I'm fearfully and wonderfully made by God that made heaven and earth and everything in it. And not even Superman could do that. Not even Batman could do that. Not even Aquaman could do that. Matter of fact, Aquaman is another form of Dagon. Dagon, his statue, fell before the Ark of the Covenant. See, and someday that's what's going to happen to America, because they're cursing God, they're mocking God, and they're not being like Job. Job was faithful, but he was cursing the day of his birth. You know, he was cursing because of the boils, the hardships that he was going through, but he was not cursing God. And I know most people would like me to say that he was cursing God, but he wasn't. And so, just that, guys. Sorry about that. That was my mom's phone. But if you guys are out there cursing God, you're in trouble. Because all them troubles that Job had will come upon you. See, things will not get better. Things will not get better. You'll die. You won't have your best life now. See, and me, yes, I live an okay life, but it's not the best. I mean, look at where I'm at in my life, you know? Just like Job, I go through troubles. I have a mortgage. I have rent to pay. I got a Subaru to pay for. I got to take care of my mom. I got a whole bunch of expenses, like a doctor bill, everything. But I thank God for them, because it humbles my heart, and I'm able to see God move in them circumstances. Matter of fact, if he wanted to, he could wipe out everything that I of my expenses. He could. Seriously, and I'll have this house for free if he wanted to. But God chooses not to help me because, yes, he loves me. But it would, with these troubles, it draws me closer to God. It draws me closer to where I can worship him. And matter of fact, today I was helping my mom, which on the return, God's word says, honor your father and your mother. And the days in the days will be long in the land that the Lord God will give it to you. See, it humbles my heart. Job, even though he was cursing his day, the day of his birth, he didn't curse God. See? And so, where I'm at in my life is sort of like Job, but not exactly. I don't have boils or anything on me. But I do have expenses. See, but I'm not going to curse God. God is my Lord and Savior. And I've seen God move in my past. And then I don't even know what he's going to do in the future. But he's given me wisdom on how to handle stuff. See, and if you come to God, if you come to Jesus for salvation and ask him in your heart to dwell with you forever, he'll do the same thing. He'd be like, I'm going to take care of my kid. I got you. See, like, I didn't even know if I was going to make the flood insurance. But now I know that I'm going to make the flood insurance. I don't know how much it's going to be, but see, that's what, with your relationship, if you have a relationship with God, that's what you will get, is internal peace. Matter of fact, that's what John 3:16 says. God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son. Whoever believes in the Son will not perish but have eternal life. And eternal life is to know the Father. It's to know the God that created heavens and earth. So, sorry, it's going to be a little bit short tonight because Job 3 was very short. But really think about it this week on what we're talking about and see Jesus, since this is Resurrection Sunday, or not Sunday, but I mean Resurrection weekend. Just think about it. Just think about what the peace you can have knowing that God has you. Because that's why Jesus said, do not worry or seek his kingdom and his righteousness and all them things be added. Is because he got you. And that's if you're a born again Christian. See, if you're born again, he got you. If you're not born again, you're in.
That's right.
That's my mom. Anyway, so I just want to leave you off with that message tonight out of Job 3. And so let's close up in prayer. And yeah. Father God, thank you for being the God of the universe and judge and controller of this universe and the people in this world. And I pray that you would just speak to the people this week, especially tomorrow and today. And Lord, I just want to thank you, God, for everything. Thank you for Job and his faithfulness towards you. And he did not curse you. And thank you for giving me a heart of thanksgiving and where I'm not cursing you every day. And thank you, God, for everything you've done, Lord. Thank you, God, for this time that we had in your word. Praise you. Thank you, God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So if you need a bike, I can hook you up. So I want to say bye for now and take care of Jesus. See you.
Happy Resurrection Day.